Let's assume that you already have some sort of home automation controller and a number of smart home components installed. With energy costs rising dramatically, you should be using them to your advantage to save you as much money as you possibly can. In this video, I'm going to very quickly run through a few ideas which are all based on automations that I'm actually using in my own home. Do you leave stuff turned on? Well, turn it off when you're not using it. There are a number of ways that you can do this, from the very simple smart plugs that switch on and off when you press a button, or you can go a bit fancier and automate turning it on and off. I have a working from home routine that detects if I'm at home on a weekday. It also checks that it's not a bank holiday and that there's no annual leave marked in the calendar too. It'll then turn on some essential components such as a mobile signal booster. At the end of the day, after 5 p.m, it'll check to see if my work laptop is still turned on. When it detects it has turned off, it'll do that routine in reverse, turning off my work kit. I've also created some standby killer automations because things like my really old Sharp TV and my Sonos speakers use quite a few watts of power when left in standby. While it's very convenient to have them ready to go, there's no need to have them on if there's nobody around to use them. I created a couple of very simple automations that monitor a room for motion. When it detects motion, it toggles a smart plug on. Connected to that smart plug is my TV kit in the living room, or in the kitchen I have a Sonos speaker and Echo Dot. All that kit suddenly jumps into life. But once my home detects that we've gone to bed because there's been a lack of motion in any of these rooms for an hour or so after a specific time in the evening, those smart plugs turn off. Idea number two is to turn even more stuff off. You can look at automating your lights using motion and look sensors, so when it starts to get dark and motion is detected in a room, they turn on. More importantly, they turn off again after a set time after motion was last detected, which means they aren't left on for hours at a time just because someone, most likely your children probably, leave them on. Check out this video if you'd like to see in more detail how I've automated that. For most households, heating is the biggest use of energy, so this should be the first thing you look at when trying to save money, because a small tweak to how you manage your heating can have a large impact on cost savings. One of the simplest ways I found to save a bit of money in our house was to simply turn off the heating if the doors were left open for more than a few minutes. There really is no point having your boiler turned on, chewing up gas, only to lose that heat straight back outside. You're basically contributing twice to global warming in one go. I made a video dedicated to showing you a few ways you can use automations to save you money on your heating bill, so you can check that out by following the link up here, and I'll also put a link to that in the description. Sticking with the heating theme, I also put together an automation that checks the weather forecast, and if it looks like it's going to be a warm day, it disables the heating for that day just to make certain that no gas is used. I'm particularly proud of this automation, and I've been using it for a few years with great success. It started life as an automation on domotics, was migrated over to SmartThings, and that same logic now runs nicely on Home Assistant. It's all detailed in that same video about heating that I put a link up to before, so please check that out. Are you on an Economy 7 tariff that gives you cheaper energy rates off peak? Or do you have an electric car on one of the many EV specific tariffs like Octopus Go? If not, switch your supplier to get one. I recommend Octopus Energy and their Octopus Go tariff, and I'll put my referral link down in the description because we'd both get £50 credit if you use it. But that aside, once you have a cheaper off-peak energy rate, you should automate as much as you can to happen during those cheap hours. Charge your car, heat your hot water, schedule your dishwasher, your washing machine, your tumble dryer. Make sure they turn on during those cheaper hours and you'll save a fortune compared to using them during the day. I published a video not long ago about the MyEnergy Eddy Solar Diverter, which you can use to heat your hot water. But even if you don't have solar, you can get timers for your immersion heater that you can use to schedule a boost off peak. They don't have to be smart, they can just be a dumb timer, but obviously they're a lot more fun if they are connected to your smart home. As for scheduling your other household appliances, a lot of them tend to have delayed start features. If you're lucky enough to have a smart appliance, then you can do things like use smart buttons to schedule them to turn on at the cheapest time. Have a look at the video I made about Home Connect smart appliances, which covers Bosch and Siemens dishwashers and tumble dryers. The same principles can apply to other brands too, with a few tweaks. you can lose a lot of heat through your windows, so making sure that your curtains and blinds are closed when it gets dark can help insulate those windows and save you money on your heating bills too. There are a lot of smart solutions out there, such as the Switchbot curtain robot and IKEA's range of smart blinds, which I've got myself, and I go over those and how I automate them based on the sun's position in this video. Have you got a smart meter installed yet? Why not? Go and get one, just call your energy supplier. Not only does it open up the world of smart tariffs to you, you'll also be given an in-home display that shows you how much energy you're using, and most importantly in my opinion is how much power you are using at any moment in time. Seeing how many watts of power you are using as devices turn on and off around your home is really important to understanding just how much energy you'll be using. Until you see those values on that display, you'll probably never have realised just how much energy your house is chewing through at night. You can use that data to make important decisions on whether your devices should be replaced, powered off, used less, that sort of thing. You can get third-party displays for your smart meter too, which let you do things like use that data in Home Assistant. I use the Glow display from Hildebrand, which I personally think is brilliant. I've made a couple of videos about this little gadget and how to connect it to Home Assistant, so please check those out. Once you've got that power and energy data into Home Assistant, you can use it in all sorts of ways. One of the most useful to me, and this is something that I've still got running in my home right now, is a visual alert that tells me when we're drawing too much power for our home battery to supply by shining a red light on the ceiling. So basically, we're drawing power from the grid and it's costing us money. The red warning light lets us know that we shouldn't turn anything else on right now. If the light is green though, then we're all good and we can turn on what we like. I built a dedicated little device for it, and you can see a video all about that project here. But even if you didn't want to build something like this, you could use the same logic in an automation to control an RGB light bulb, or even send a notification to your phone. And those are my top 8 suggestions. I'm sure there are many more, so if you have any ideas, then please let me and everyone else know in the comments, and I might put together another video with even more ideas in. Saving energy is important for our pockets and the environment, so the more ideas the better. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.